Hello guys, and welcome back to another episode of the F123 Renault Career. But this is the final episode, because F124 is out. So, we will simulate practice 1, but not practice 2. Practice to time.
We've estimated the times our closest rivals will be doing, so that's what we need to beat.
For practice 2, I want to do some tasks, so I get some upgrades. No way! I was on such a good lap!
Confirmed, we'll receive you at the end of this lap.
Let's do another one lap. crew.
Job
nice.
Indeed. You got a lot of valuable information out of that. Well done. Car repairs have set us back a little.
Now let's do another task. We'll be right back. Finally, it's done. And with that, practice two is done, so now let's head to practice three. Are there any upgrades that we can afford? Yes, there are. And another one. And now let's go to qualifying. The track is wet, so I will go on the full wet tires.
Track is wet right now. Feel your way around the conditions before you start pushing the car. That's a not so good lap, so let's do another lap. Fastest sector 1 and 2.
What a nice lap. I think it's a good enough lap for Q1.
Okay, recommend.
Oh my God, that's first, and Novalik is 21st. Because it's still wet, I will take the full wet tire.
Take it easy to start with, the track's very wet.
What a good lap.
Pitting this lap then, come into the pits at the end of this lap.
Who had to retire after receiving wheel number 4.
What? We are the fastest driver in Q2. No way. Well, that sucks. So let's go to the race, I guess.
Well, once upon a time, this used to be the season opener before it fell victim to a pandemic reshuffling. But now Albert Park is back at the heart of the F1 calendar. So welcome to Sunkissed Melbourne for the Australian Grand Prix. We go racing today then in the state of Victoria, where the drivers have 14 corners and 3.28 miles to navigate at an average lap speed of around 120 miles per hour. The close proximity of the barriers make accidents inevitable, and recent history shows us that a safety car is not at all out of the question. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position, edging out Sergio Perez, who lines up P2. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Stevens, Leclerc, Norris, Sainz, Russell, Oscar Piastri, Hamilton, Fernando Alonso, Gasly, Ocon, Stroll, Magnussen, Albon, Tsunoda, Joe, Hülkenberg, Ricciardo, Bottas, Novalak, and Logan Sargeant. And now it's time to head down to the track. And a warm welcome, of course, to my co-commentator here today, it's Natalie Pinkham. Why don't we kick off by discussing Max Verstappen?
What a quali performance. The big question, though, is how does that translate on race day? Can they hold on to that lead? One more thing to consider is the strategy element. How far can the drivers push these tyres? And who is going to blink first for fresh rubber? It'll be interesting to see if the leaders have to compromise their plan to cover off the cars behind them.
So let's choose the strategy and start the race.
Map is good, but we need to learn the gear. Okay,
nice.
Incredible parking there, nice one. That's going to give you the edge if you can get good launch as the race starts. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient and watch for those lights.
Oh my God, we are second. What an amazing start. Let's try and catch up to Max. Oh no, I got off the track, and now Checo is catching me. as I also make contact with Norris. Now we are back to zero. No, I run wide. And now Hamilton hits us. What is he doing? Also, because we have wing damage, I will change the front wing. Why is it taking so long? Well, thank you, pit crew. That was the worst pit stop I have ever seen. Look at that pit stop. It's horrible. Today our pit crew is awful. Look at McLaren. While we had the horrible pit stops, McLaren had the best pit stops. So in this lap, Verstappen pitted, so Checo leads the race. Because we had a horrible pit stop, we have to overtake some cars when the safety car leaves. Finally, safety car in this lap. Nice. We are in the points.
Nice move. Good job.
Oh no, our gearbox is at 60%. Looks like Leclerc and Piastri are fighting. This is our chance to close on them. What an overtake! Finally, some DRS.
Okay, good work. Great
yes,
pass.
Another position up. Let's go from 11th to 6th.
Okay, so the gap to the car ahead, 2.7 seconds.
So Gasly got damage, so he will box. Let's go. Now we don't have the worst pit stop. Not again.
Issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Okay, information on site. Okay, it looks like the problem's terminal. They're retiring the car.
Oh my god, a second safety car.
No overtaking, reduce.
In the restart, we must gain at least one position. Finally, amazing! We are fourth. Final lap, let's finish at least fourth. GG.
All right, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
Another superb Australian Grand Prix comes to an end then, and it's a thoroughly deserved victory. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Quite simply, a driver is nothing without the team behind them. So, a deserved winner, but we do have to give a shout out to the team in the pit lane and back at the factory. Very much a collaborative process.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently, and it's clear to see that they've put in the work, and they should be so proud of the victory they've secured here.
Well, that was a good episode.
Let's have a look.
Love you guys and see you at the next video.
Max Verstappen now leads the Drivers' Championship. Let's focus.